This is video 2. We will continue with environmental sanitation. So when we say environmental sanitation, as first of all, we know that it is very important, okay, maintaining the environmental sanitation. As a nurse, when you go to the community area, it is important for you to instruct the people, because whenever, you know, environmental sanitation is not maintained, then it leads to lots of diseases, okay, like stagnation of water leads to the spread of, you know, the mosquitoes breed in the water, okay, and if it is a pure water, again, no stagnation should be done. So, you know, diseases like dengue is more common, okay, now COVID-19 again, right? So we have to be very careful with our environmental sanitation, no stagnation of water, proper disposal of the waste, you know, and making sure, you know, that this education is given to the community people. So we will see what are the other things that we have to keep in mind when it comes to environmental sanitation. So the most difficult problem to tackle in this country is perhaps the environmental sanitation problem, which is multifaceted and multifactorial. The twin problems of environmental sanitation are lack of safe water in many areas of the country and primitive methods of excreta disposal. So there are two problems when we say environmental sanitation is there could be lack of safe water, okay, in many areas of the country and primitive methods of excreta disposal. So proper disposal of the excreta. So in community areas, we should make sure that they use latrines, okay, and OFD should be prevented. What is OFD? Open field defecation. Just not passing motion wherever they want. Again, it leads to lots of other diseases like worm infestation, okay, and then we have to be very careful that they do, and it leads to typhoid if it gets contaminated with the drinking water. Besides these, there have been a growing concern about the impact of new problems resulting from population explosion, urbanization and industrialization, leading to hazards to human health in the air, in water and in food chain. So besides these, we also see that there are so many new problems that are arising because of population explosion. So we will be studying about population. So when we say population explosion, these are the disasters that occur or challenges that occur because of the increase in the population. Okay, so urbanization, like people moving from rural areas in search of, you know, jobs to urban areas. So that is called as urbanization. And industrialization, development of various industries, you know, in the cities or in the villages, is called as industrialization. So all these actually adds to the health hazards of human health, and they also become a reason for pollution of air, water, as well as in the food chain. There are changes. So at the United Nations Water Conference in Argentina in 1977, it was recommended that the priority should be given to the provision of safe water supply and sanitation services to all by the year 1990, and the period 1981 to 1990 was designated as the International Water Supply and Sanitation Decade. So already we have seen in India, you know, that safe water supply was provided in the health program. We have discussed very, you know, elaborately the various health program, same, you know, in rural as well as in the urban area. So what were the various program, you know, how panchayat people were involved, the participation of the people, okay, so all that we have seen. So here in United Nations Water Conference was conducted in Argentina in the year 1977, and then in that meeting they recommended that priority should be given for the provision of good water supply and sanitation services for all by the year 1990. And the period 1981 to 1990, during that period they designated for about, you know, 9 years, okay, so it was designated that it was designated as International Water Supply and Sanitation Decade, okay, so that year, okay. So as of 2006, safe water is available. So when we see from the year 2006, we see that there is safe water available to 96% of urban and 86% of the rural population, and adequate facilities for waste disposal to 52% of the urban and 18% of the rural population. We have seen that. Okay, so as of year from 2006, we see that safe water is available to 96% of the urban and 86% of the rural population, and adequate facilities for water disposal to 52% of urban and 18% of rural population. So 96% of people started getting safe water in the urban areas and 86% of the rural population, and adequate facilities for water disposal to about 52% in the urban and 18% waste disposal, 52% urban and 18% of the rural population. So by 2006 they have achieved this, but by now I think 2020 we should have still more achieved. Okay, so waste disposal and water supply, safe water supply is very important. So environmental sanitation, again the water should not be contaminated. So contaminated water leads to various health problems like cholera, typhoid. Okay, and then we also see that if environmental sanitation, proper waste disposal has to be done. If proper waste disposal is not done, again it leads to lots of disorder. So stagnation of water and improper waste disposal can be hazardous to the population. So that has to be taken care. So this is about environmental sanitation. And the last topic of the unit will be in the next video.